Okay, so in example 7, it says give the contrapositive and the converse of each statement and give the truth value of each. Okay, so it says if a bird is small, it is a hummingbird. So it sounds like it's going hypothesis and then conclusion. Hypothesis is that the bird is small, conclusion is that it's a hummingbird. So the contrapositive would be if it is not a hummingbird, then the bird is not small. So just because you're not a hummingbird, does that mean that you're a large bird? Are there birds that are not hummingbirds that are small? Yeah. So is this a true statement or a false statement? The statement is false. B. If two non-vertical lines have the same slope, they are parallel. So then what's the contrapositive? If two lines are parallel, then the two lines are the two non-vertical lines. Sorry. If the two lines are not parallel, then the two non-vertical lines do not have the same slope. So say we have two lines that are not parallel, then the two non-vertical lines do not have the same slope. So is that a true statement? Yeah, that's true. We need to go back to A. So this was the contrapositive. Contrapositive. We need to also mention the converse. The converse. Like the truth. Anyway. So converse. The converse would be you just switch the hypothesis and conclusion. So if it is a hummingbird, then it is a small bird. Now, is this true? This is true. Okay. So in one case, in both cases, we're switching the hypothesis and conclusion, but in one case, we're negating both the hypothesis and conclusion, and in one case, we're not. And you see how we got different truth values for the two. Let's go back to B. So then we also need to do the converse. If two lines are parallel, then the two non-vertical lines have the same slope. So is that true or false? And let's put if two non-vertical lines are not parallel, then the two non-vertical lines do not have the same slope. Let's write it like this. If two non-vertical lines are parallel, then the two non-vertical lines have the same slope. Is that true? Yeah, that's true. Okay. Let's look at C. If we're in Paris, then we must be in France. So, this was the contrapositive, and this was the converse. So let's look at the contrapositive for this one. So, if we are not in France, then we are not in Paris. Yeah, because Paris is in France, and if you're not in France, then you can't be in Paris. So then that should be true. And then the converse, if we are in France, then we are in Paris. So is it possible to be in France without being in Paris? Yeah, that's true. So this isn't necessarily true. So just because you're in France doesn't mean you're in Paris. So then this is false. Let's see. True and false. Okay. And then D. The contrapositive, it says, so we want to talk about the contrapositive first. If a road is one way, you cannot legally make a U-turn. Okay. So the contrapositive is, if you can legally make a U-turn, then the road is not a one way. Should be true. And then the converse, if you cannot legally make a U-turn, then the road is a one way. So just because you can't make a U-turn, does that imply that the road is a one way? I would say that's false. So let's see if D is correct. True and false, yeah. So these should be good. If you have questions, don't hesitate to ask Dr. Wilson or email me. Okay.